So we're in Harrisburg today and we're talking about people with disabilities and how policies here at the state level can allow them to lead a full and productive life. Pennsylvania has a program called Medical Assistance for Workers with Disabilities, called MAWD, M-A-W-D. And what it allows is folks that have a disability often need home and community-based services. They might need a home health aide to come in, perhaps some equipment, prescription drug assistance. And when they go into the workforce, they could become ineligible for benefits. Now, the MAWD program allows those folks to continue to receive those medical assistance benefits, but there's caps right now on what they can earn. So they can only earn, on a household basis, 250% of the federal poverty level. So if you're a single individual, that's slightly less than $32,000. If you're married, a couple of two, that's right around $43,000. The other limit is that they can only have up to $10,000 in assets. That includes retirement assets. So that's a pretty low bar. And so what we're seeing is people who are well-educated, who have significant opportunities in the workforce that cannot stay in the workforce or earn higher levels of income because of these limits, or they can't get married. So we heard from two people today. We heard from a lady who has a doctorate degree in healthcare ethics. She receives 24-hour services at home. She's highly functioning. But she needs those services because of her disability. She needs a ventilator. She needs prescription drugs that cost, out of pocket, would cost $2,000 a month. So she's got to not earn what her potential is with that doctorate degree because of the caps and the limits. Another lady, she's got a fiance, would like to get married. She was a nurse. Because of her disability, now she's had to scale back and she works in the arts community 15 hours a week, but she can't get married because her spouse has more than $10,000 worth of assets and retirement income. So there's a proposal in Harrisburg, House Bill 1115, that would lift those caps, allow those folks to lead a fully productive life. Now there's some stipulations there. You know, they have to be in the workforce for at least 12 months. They have to work at least 40 hours a month. They have to earn at least minimum wage. But we call them workers with job success. It would create a new category within the medical assistance program, workers with job success, where those caps would be eliminated, those barriers would be eliminated. Now, they do pay a premium, and they would pay a significant premium. But what we find is, for the average person with disabilities, it's about $4,000 a month for them to have home and community-based services. Who could afford that? How can we tell them they can never own a home because you can't have the savings that you would need? How can we tell them that you can't get married, that you can't have retirement assets? These are all things that, you know, if we lift those caps, if we pass this law, not only can they lead a more full and productive life, but they're going to be paying taxes. They're going to be contributing back to society. They're going to be paying that additional premium to the program. And so we all win if we can do this, and we can help fund this also through the tobacco settlement funds. So these are monies that Pennsylvania receives every year from the big tobacco companies that was part of a global settlement that was achieved. So I am hopeful that we can pass this legislation, remove these barriers, allow these folks to lead a more productive life, and allow all of us to enjoy the benefits of that.